Hi, welcome to the DeKalb High School Reach and Teach Campus Tour episode being brought to you by Big Red Sports. I'm Pearson.
And I'm Jacob. We have four great segments to share with you today.
First, we'll make some grilled cheese sandwiches with Coach Hall and Coach Collins.
Next, we will see which of our area mascots would win in a fight with Ranker.
Stay tuned and we'll answer some crucial questions with nine needless questions.
But first, we're going to test our self-control with I'm Weak. So for today's segment, we're doing I'm Weak, and we're basically going to be telling dry jokes and just trying to see who gets the most laughs. I'm Owen. We have Clayton right there, and then Pearson, and then Jason is recording.
Howdy.
Let's get to it. You know.
How many apples grow on a tree?
How many?
All of them.
So dumb. What do you call a snail who it doesn't have a shell?
What?
It's dead.
A man goes up to his doctor and says, "Doc, help me. I'm addicted to Twitter." The doctor replies, "Sorry, I don't follow you."
Okay.
All right, what did the blanket say as it fell off the bed?
What?
Oh, sheep.
Cheers.
Yeah. Alright, this one's pretty good. Why did the old man fall down the well?
Why?
Because he couldn't see that well.
Where do you send sick boats?
Where?
To the docks. Oh my god. To the docks.
If you ever get cold, just stand in a corner for a bit. They're usually around 9 degrees.
That's a classic.
How do you get a squirrel to like you?
Oh.
Act like a nut.
All right, so that concludes today's segment of I'm Weak. Clayton got the most laughs, so he definitely won. That concludes the segment. Hope you have a good day.
Clayton definitely had the most self-control.
Next up, a battle of the grilled cheese with Coach Collins and Coach Hall. Who will win this?
Who will win it, Barons? I'm Jacob. This is our segment, Cooking with Coaches. Let's meet our contestants.
On our side, we have Coach Collins.
Wow!
And then we have Coach Hall. Who is
wow!
Coach here.
I think you maybe needed some more spray on the pan.
If you don't stay over there and record. Everybody was all for Team Hall. They brought her stove from home. This is the stove from her house. Has a little curve-ish on.
We weren't fancy back in the LP. We just cut our grilled cheese right down the middle.
I wasn't fancy either, but I was dreaming to be fancy.
You want
to
cut it down to the diagonal? You can do it yourself. It doesn't affect the taste.
Diagonal definitely makes it taste better, I'll be honest.
That's what that is.
That's pretty solid though.
That's pretty solid though. Bro, I don't trust your taste with
it. Try that one right there, Rosie.
Come on, Rose.
Let's
turn this
thing. He didn't come to this palette.
Let's Arthur Sandy!
Oh, great.
Oh. Alright, now that we have our grilled cheeses cooked, cheesed, whatever you want to say.
Alright, so Rosie, what are your thoughts on grilled cheese number one?
Pretty good.
They were both really good. They're gonna be tough. And number one probably was my favorite.
Who takes home the winner?
Not like Josh's cheese.
Hey, so come on, man. Come on.
Fair enough, Rosie. Fair enough.
Fair enough, hey. Rose.
I'm going to have to go with Miss Hall.
Oh, we got a tiebreaker?
Miss Hall.
Ah! What?
what?
All right, thank you guys for joining us in our segment. We'll catch you next time. All right, it's pretty solid.
Nice.
Coach Hall with the win over Coach Collins in the Battle of the Grilled Cheeses.
Definitely a tasty competition.
Our next segment is Battle of the Mascots with Ranker, sponsored by C.L. Johnson Landscaping.
Hi, welcome to Ranker, brought to you by C.L. Johnson Landscaping. I am your host, Caleb.
And I'm Blake. Today we will be ranking the mascots in our school's conference. The winners will be determined in who would win in a fight style, and the winners will be determined by our teachers' opinions.
All right, what do you guys think? Barons or Bulldogs?
I think hands down, Barons. Like a bulldog, flat face, kind of like, you know, when it walks around, it loses its breath, so.
I think the Baron makes the bulldog a pet, and yeah, Baron all
that's,
day.
That one's easy.
All right,
that's,
yeah, we got Baron. Sure. All right, in this matchup, we have the Braves versus the Eagles.
Oh, that's, come on, man. Eagle.
Yeah.
Eagle.
I have to agree with the Eagle.
Eagle.
Unanimous,
yeah.
Eagle?
Yeah.
All right. All right, guys, now we have the Lions versus the Knights.
That's easy. It's easy.
What do you think?
The Knight. The what? Knight wins. The Knight wins.
There's no way. There's no way that a Knight beats a Lion. If you're all of your armor off
have,
of you, and Molly, I need you
up. I have defense. Look,
listen, Mufasa is coming in. Maul, head gone. See you, Knight. That's all that's happening right there.
All right.
See, but the Lion King in it.
We have a divided decision here.
Knights.
Lions.
All right, and our last matchup of the first round is the Vikings versus the Knights.
I have to go with Knights on this one because Vikings are on a ship. All you gotta do is put a hole in that ship. No. Down go the Vikings. Knights win. He's going with gut.
I'm gonna go with the Vikings.
All right, we got another split decision.
Oh.
All right, Mr. Gaff, who would win in a fight, a lion or a knight?
Noble's knight is usually depicted. He does have a sword, so I don't see him having too much of a chance against a lion. They're pretty scary, and go ahead, and I'm going to have to give a nod to the lion over his noble knight.
Lion it is. Okay, for the next one, a Viking or a knight?
I have to say that a lance isn't really going to do a whole lot against a horde of Vikings. So I'm gonna go with the Vikings on that one.
Vikings.
All right, who do you think would win? Lions or Vikings?
Oh, Lions, no doubt. You know the rules, and so
do I. All right, in this matchup, we have a Baron versus an Eagle. Who do you think would win?
The Baron's has a lot of armor. It's got a horseback. Got the sword. Eagles are up in the air though. But I definitely, just with the weaponry of the Baron and the speed of the horse, I'd go with the Baron.
Alrighty.
Oh my goodness, an eagle.
Okay. Alright, we're here with Mr. Johnson in the final round, championship round. So who do you think would win, a lion or a Baron?
Oh, that's a tough one. A Baron has all that armor, so a lion's not going to be able to, like, get his teeth into him. And then a Baron's sure. also going to have some sort of weapon, so I'm going to have to say that a Baron would beat a lion.
There we go. This was Ranker, brought to you by C.L. Johnson Landscape.
And Barons win. What a shocker.
Ever needed the answers to crucial questions?
We have the answers for you with 9 needless questions.
Hello and welcome to our segment. I'm Bo.
And I'm Grant, and this is 9 Needless Questions. In this segment, we will be asking our fellow student 9 random questions. And this is Logan.
Okay, the first question is, what does the SAT stand for?
That's a good question.
The Scholastic Assessment Test.
I couldn't plug you that one.
All right, are unicorns extinct?
Not even. Can they be extinct if they're not real?
What's your answer?
I mean, no.
Correct. Right.
Okay, what planet is closest to the sun?
Mercury?
Great answer, bro.
Alright, what is the only animal that can't jump? Yeah. What is the only animal that can't jump?
The elephant.
Seems like you've been asked that before.
What is the biggest muscle of the human body?
The glutes.
Alright, who is the king of pop?
Of pop?
Yeah, like music.
Michael Jackson.
He is cool. Okay, this is opinionated. Is cereal a soup?
Is cereal a soup? No. I'd have to say no.
Explain. All right, who painted the Mona Lisa?
Da Vinci.
Okay, and then the last one, who invented the light bulb?
Thomas Edison.
All right. That's it.
Thanks for watching our segment. We hope you enjoy and have an absolutely splendid day.
Alright, and that concludes our episode for today.
Thanks for watching the DeKalb High School Reach and Teach Campus Tour episode, brought to you by Big Red Sports.
Don't forget to share with all your friends.